Hello students. Students, in this lecture we will study about the conformation of cells. In the previous lectures we had studied about the conformation of resistors, conformation of capacitors. In the same way, in this lecture we will study about the conformation of cells. First we will study the series conformation and then parallel conformation. You know the symbol of cell is this. This vertical longer line shows the positive terminal of the cell, and this smaller vertical line shows the negative terminal of the cell, and the electromotive force of cell is generated by epsilon. Somewhere the electromotive force of cell is generated by capital E, but here we are taking epsilon, and the internal resistance of cell is generated by small r. Somewhere the internal resistance of cell is shown here near the cell. This is R plus minus. There is no difference between the diagrams. Here you have not to disturb. Okay. Now let the first cell is this positive terminal and negative, and the electromotive force epsilon 1, the internal resistance R 1. Let this is point A and this is point B. Okay. Another cell is there, positive terminal, negative terminal, of electromotive force epsilon 2 and of internal resistance small r. Okay. In the series combination, the second end of previous cell is connected to the first end of next cell. This is called the series combination. So this end is connected to this end, and let this is point C. Now the potential difference between A and B will be V A B. It will be the higher potential minus lower potential, because this is connected to the positive, that's why here higher potential will be there. Okay. Now you know that the terminal potential V is equal epsilon minus I into R. This is the relation between terminal potential, electromotive force and internal resistance. So from this equation, the potential difference between point A and B will be VAB, will be equal epsilon 1 minus IR1. Because these are connected in series, that's why current will be same for each cell. So this will be the potential or the terminal potential between point A and B. Okay, let this is equation first, and now the potential difference between point B and C will be V BC, higher potential VB, lower potential VC. From this equation, the potential difference between point B and C will be VBC equal epsilon 2 minus IR2. Okay, this. Now the potential difference between A and C will be VAC. It will be equal potential difference, potential at point A minus potential at point C. Higher potential will be at point A. Okay. This is the potential difference between point A and C. Now, in this equation, here VA subtract VB and add VB in this equation, then this equation will be VA minus VB plus VB minus VC. It is equal VAC. But this is equal to this. Okay. What is the value? VA minus VB is the potential difference between point A and B. And the potential difference between point A and B means VAB. And plus, this is the potential difference between B and C. So it will be VBC. It is equal VAC. But the value of VAB is this. From first equation, that this is second equation. From first equation, epsilon 1 minus I into R1 plus the value of VBC, epsilon 2 minus I R2. This is equal VAC. Okay. You know, this is positive and this is also positive. So we can write here epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 minus I R1 minus I R2. Or epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2, and we can take minus common, minus and I common. So R1 plus R2 will be there. It is equal to VAB. Oh, sorry, VAC. Okay. You know, if we are comparing this equation by this equation, from this equation, then this is equal to epsilon equivalent minus I. This will be equal R equivalent, and the potential difference between A and C, we can write this V equivalent. Okay. Here, epsilon equivalent is equal to epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2. And in the place of R equivalent, R1 plus R2 will be there. Okay. Now, in this combination, the equivalent electromotive force is equal to the sum of the equivalent EMF or electromotive force of individual cells, and the equivalent in the and the equivalent internal resistance of the combination is equal to the sum of the internal resistances of individual cells. So this is the formula for the numerical problems. Okay, now second here parallel combination is there. So we will discuss about the parallel combination of cells. So let this is the first cell. This is the first cell, positive terminal, negative terminal, and this is the second cell, positive terminal, negative terminal. Let the electromotive force of first cell is epsilon 1 and the internal resistance is R1. And the electromotive force of second cell, epsilon 2, and the internal resistance is R2. Okay. When the positive terminal of all cells are connected to one common point, and the negative terminals are connected to another common point, then this combination is called the parallel combination. Okay. Now, the current drawn from first cell will be I1, and from second I2. So the total or equivalent current of the combination will be I. Here, these are connected in parallel. That's why here the potential difference between point A and B from first cell and second cell will be same. So here the equivalent or the total current flowing through the combination will be I1 plus I2. Okay. Let this is equation first. Now you know that the terminal potential, electromotive force, and this is the internal resistance. This is the relation between these. Okay. From this equation, for first cell, potential difference is same for each. That's why here will be, for first cell, V will be equal epsilon 1 minus I1, because through I1, through cell first, here I1 current is flowing, and the internal resistance of first R1. Okay, from this equation, we have to find the value of I1 and we have to put the value of I1 in this equation. So from this equation, V minus epsilon 1 minus epsilon 1 equal minus I1 R1. Okay, this is minus. So on multiplying by minus in both sides, then it will be epsilon 1 minus V equal I1 R1. Okay, epsilon. Or here I1 will be epsilon 1 minus V upon R1. Okay, similarly for second cell, the current I2 will be epsilon 2 minus V upon R2. Okay, on putting the value of I1 and I2 in equation first, so I will be equal the value of I1, epsilon 1 minus V upon R1, and plus value of I2, epsilon 2 minus V upon R2. Or here epsilon 1 upon R1 minus V upon R1 plus epsilon 2 upon R2 minus V upon R2. This equation can be written as this equation. Okay, so now here V and V is common for this and this. So here will be, this is positive and this is also positive. So epsilon 1 upon R1 plus epsilon 2 upon R2, and here we can take minus and V from both. So here will be minus V in R1 plus 1 upon R2. Okay, now it is equal to I. Okay, so we can write from this equation I equal I1, we can add the values. So the LCM of R1 and R2 will be R1 R2, and on cross multiplication, here epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1, epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1. Okay, so this, and minus the LCM of R1 R2, V R1 R2 cross multiplication of 1 and R2, R2 plus R1 will be there. Cross multiplication of 1 and R2 equal R2, and cross multiplication of R1 and 1 equal R1. Okay, now we can transfer the value of this in left side and the value of this in right side. So here V, this is negative, so here will be positive. So V R1, these are positive. So we can write R1 plus R2 upon R1 R2 and equal epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 R2, and this is positive, so here will be negative I. Okay, now we have to simplify this equation in the form of this equation. Okay, so here V equal epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 into R2 upon, here will be R1 plus R2 upon R1 R2. Okay, and minus minus I upon R1 plus R2 upon R1 R2. Okay. Or V equal, this will be epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 into R2, and into it will go to the numerator, so R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 will be there, and minus minus here it will go to the numerator, so I into R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. Okay, now in this equation here R1 into R2 cancel, R1 into R2, so here will be V equal epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 plus R2. Okay, and minus I R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. This equation is similar to V equal epsilon minus I R. Okay, we can compare this equation from this equation. So in the place of epsilon, here the value is this, and in the place of R, here this value is there. Okay, so on comparing these equations, here epsilon equivalent, because this is the equation for equivalent, okay, combination, so it will be equal epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 plus R2. This is the equivalent electromotive force of the combination. And here I is there, so R equivalent will be equal R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. Okay, so now the equivalent electromotive force of the parallel combination is this, and the formula of equivalent internal resistance for the combination of cells is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2. Okay, this is the value. Now from this equation, let this is equation third, and this is fourth equation. Now from these equations, here when we will solve this, we will get the epsilon equivalent upon R equivalent will be epsilon 1 upon R1 plus epsilon 2 upon R2, and 1 upon R equivalent will be equal 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2. Do you know why cells are connected? From a single cell, very feeble current is drawn. Okay, for to find the higher current, we are combining the cells. Okay, so firstly we have to understand about the special cases of cell. First, when let two cells are connected in series, let the electromotive force of each cell is equal, and the internal resistance of each cell is also equal. Okay, let the internal resistance of first cell is shown here, and the internal resistance of second cell is here. This combination is connected to the external resistor, external load. Here this load may be the bulb or any electrical devices, cell, bulb or torch, like that. So the resistance, this resistance is called external resistance. Okay, current will be drawing from first cell along this direction and from second cell along this direction. So the total current will be I. Okay, now you know that in the previous step we have studied that the equivalent internal resistance and the equivalent electromotive force of the series combination is epsilon equivalent equal epsilon first plus epsilon second. The electromotive force of first cell and this is the electromotive force of second cell. Okay, but in this combination here two cells are connected and the electromotive force of each is equal, means the electromotive force of first is epsilon and the electromotive force of second is also epsilon. It is equal epsilon equivalent. Okay, or here 2 epsilon will be there and it will be equal equivalent, epsilon equivalent. This is the equivalent epsilon, means equivalent electromotive force of the series combination of two cells. If in this combination here 3 cells are connected, then the electromotive force or the equivalent electromotive force will be 3 epsilon. If 4 cells are connected here, then the total or equivalent electromotive force will be 4 epsilon. Okay, now if n cells are connected in series, then the total or equivalent electromotive force will be n epsilon. Okay, now and the equivalent internal resistance of this series combination we have studied, R equivalent, the expression is R equivalent at R1 plus R2 if two cells are connected. If three cells, but the internal resistance of both are equal, so first internal resistance of first cell plus internal resistance of second cell, it will be equal to R and it is equal R equivalent. If three cells are connected, then the internal resistance will be 3R, and if the N cells are connected, then the internal resistance will be N small r. This is equal R equivalent, means the in total or equivalent internal resistance of the combination will be N and NR. Okay, now the current drawn from the cell or the maximum current drawn from the combination from the combination will be I maximum. It will be equal the maximum potential difference between two ends of the combination upon the total resistance of combination. Okay, maximum potential difference, what is the maximum potential difference? When cell is open or the circuit is open or no current is flowing through the combination, then this is said to be open. And in the open circuit or when circuit is open, the maximum potential difference between two electrodes of the cell is said to be the electromotive force. Okay, so the maximum potential difference between the between two ends of the combination will be equal to the equivalent electromotive force of the combination. So here equivalent electromotive force of the combination is epsilon equivalent. Okay, and the total resistance, this is the combination and this external resistor or load is connected to the combination in series. So the total resistance will be external resistance plus internal resistance. Total internal resistance or equivalent internal resistance is R equivalent. The value of epsilon equivalent is N epsilon when N cells are connected. So N epsilon and R plus the value of R equivalent is N R. Okay, this is the expression for the maximum current drawn from the cell. Let this is equation first. Okay, now when what is the condition for maximum current drawn from the combination? So first case, if R, small r means internal resistance is very very less than capital R. In this case, here R can be neglected. So when R can be neglected means the value of R may be zero. So in this part here, the zero will be there. So the maximum current drawn from the combination will be N epsilon upon R. Okay. And I maximum equal N into epsilon upon R. This is the number of cells connected in series and this is the electromotive force upon resistance of external resistor. So this is the current drawn from one single cell. So here current drawn from the combination is N time of the current drawn from one cell. Okay, this is the first case. Second case, if R is very very greater than capital R, then I maximum will be from this equation, from equation first, N epsilon upon here. For this case, R can be neglected. So from this equation, I maximum will be N into R. N cancel. So here I maximum will be epsilon upon R. This. Okay. And this is the maximum current drawn from the combination of cells. This current is equal to the current drawn from a single cell. So if the current drawn from the single cell, if the current drawn from the combination is equal to the current drawn from a single cell, that this combination is not beneficial in the series combination. So when this combination is beneficial, in first cases, when the internal resistance of each cell is greater than the R, then the combination is not beneficial. But if the internal resistance of each cell is very very small than the external resistance, then current is drawn from the combination is N time of the current drawn from a single cell. In this case, when the internal resistance of each cell is smaller than the external resistance, then this combination will be beneficial. If two cells of equal electromotive force and equal internal resistance are connected in parallel, let this is first cell of electromotive force epsilon and this is second cell of electromotive force epsilon, and let the internal resistance of this is shown here, it is equal small r, and the internal resistance of second is shown here and it is equal r, are connected in parallel. Okay, and this is external circuit in this external circuit, the resistor, it may be, or the load, it may be the bulb or the torch or any other electric device. And the resistance of this external circuit or load is capital R. Current drawn from this cell will same for each cell. Okay, now current is total current I will be flowing through the external circuit. So this is the combination. In the previous step, we have studied that the equivalent electromotive force of the parallel combination is epsilon equivalent equal epsilon 1 R2 plus epsilon 2 R1 upon R1 plus R2. Because electromotive force for both cells are equal, that's why it is equal epsilon into resistance, internal resistance equal. So epsilon R upon R plus R will be there, and it will be equal to epsilon R upon 2R. R 2 cancel, R cancel. Equivalent electromotive force for the combination is E. If here N cells are connected in the parallel combination, then the equivalent electromotive force will be same. Okay, now the equivalent internal resistance small R equivalent, it is equal. In the previous step, we have studied that the expression for equivalent internal resistance is R1 R2 upon R1 plus R2 for the combination of two cells. Okay, now because R1 and R2 are equal, so R into R upon R plus R or R square upon here 2R, R upon R cancel and R upon 2 will be there. It is equal R equivalent. So this is the equivalent internal resistance for the combination of two cells. If here three cells are connected, then the equivalent internal resistance will be R upon 3. If four cells are connected in parallel, then the equivalent internal resistance will be R upon 4. Okay, if n cells are connected, then the equivalent internal resistance will be R upon n. This is the formula or expression for the equivalent internal resistance of the combination. Okay, now the current drawn from the combination, what will be the maximum current? Maximum current will be maximum potential difference between the two points of the combination upon total resistance of the combination. Maximum potential difference, you know that the maximum potential difference is equal to the electromotive force. When will be the maximum potential difference? When circuit will be opened. Okay, in that condition, potential difference between two electrodes of cell will be maximum. That's why the maximum potential difference will be equal to the electromotive force, equivalent electromotive force. And here for the combination, equivalent electromotive force is epsilon. So here maximum potential difference will be equal to epsilon for parallel combination, and the total resistance will be external resistance plus internal resistance. Internal resistance is equal R equivalent. Now epsilon, this is equal to maximum, I maximum, R plus the value of R equivalent is R upon N. Okay, now from this equation, let this equation is second equation. From this equation, if first case, if R is very, very less, then then capital R. Then from this equation, small r can be neglected. So in this case, I maximum will be epsilon upon this step will be neglected. So here R will be there. So it is equal to the current drawn from the one cell, only one cell. So you know here when two or more or n cells are connected in parallel, then the maximum current of the combination is equal to the current drawn from one cell. So this is not beneficial. In which condition? In which case? If the internal resistance of each cell is smaller than the external resistance, in this case the combination is not beneficial. So when will be it beneficial? So we will discuss it. Second case, if small r is very very greater than capital R, in this case from second equation, here R is maximum, so capital R can be neglected. So I maximum will be epsilon upon R upon N, or it is equal N into epsilon R. So the maximum current when the internal resistance of each cell is greater than the external resistance, then the current drawn from the combination is n time of the current drawn from one cell. In this case when R is very very greater than capital R, in this case the parallel combination of the cells is beneficial. Okay, so why two or more cells are connected in series or in parallel? To find the higher current. Okay, and the combination of cells is said to be the battery. So when two or more cells are connected in series, then if the internal resistance of each cell is negligible, or internal resistance of each cell is smaller than the external resistance, then in the series combination cell is beneficial, because combination is beneficial because the current drawn from the combination is n time of the number of n time of the current drawn from one cell. And second, if one or more cells are connected in parallel, then if internal resistance is greater than the external resistance, then parallel combination is beneficial. And in the series combination, when internal resistance of each cell is smaller than capital R, then the series combination of cells will be beneficial. Okay, you understood? Thanks.